My first two films, having not worked in the box office, put me in a kind of a vulnerable position. You know, my directorial career was almost finished. I realized that if I have to come back as a director, it has to be with this film. When I was writing the script and I structured everything around Aamir, I also told Aamir that, you know, if we have the British actors, I want to get them from London, not cast them within India.
Hi everyone, today we have with us Ashutosh Govarikar. Thank you so much, Ashutosh, for taking time out to do this with the Quint. Thank you so much for creating this cult, which I think even today, if we play in a room, everyone as a part of the family will be able to enjoy. But if I would ask you to go back in time and tell us about how, you know, this came to be, like, you know, you came up with the story, you came up with the screenplay, of course, and then you put on this whole cast together, which just fell into place, you know, every character.
Let me tell you about the casting part of it, because that was the most important phase, starting, of course, with Aamir. You know, when I was writing the script, I structured everything around Aamir, because our association on our previous film, which is called Bazi, which is an action thriller, was very good, though box office-wise, the film did not do too well. But still, I felt that for something like Lagaan and for Bhuvan, Aamir was the apt choice. We worked out the nuances of every character that you see in the film, be it the villagers or be it the British, the cantonment, and how they forget their differences and come together to fight this common enemy. So some actors were already there on my wish list, but there were others like, you know, Raghuveer Yadav, someone I wanted to work with, Rajesh Vivek, Kulbhushan Karbanda ji, then Suhasini Mule ji, because it really becomes a mixed bag of different actors from very different walks of life. And especially then going to London and doing auditions there and casting the British actors. So Paul Blackthorne and Rachel Shelley from London.
But did it seem ambitious for you, like when you were taking on this and you, I mean, not a lot of people back then, you know, like we're talking about 2001 or, you know, you probably started working on it even earlier. Back then, not a lot of people would have thought that we'll get English on the cast, you know.
It did seem ambitious, you're right, because this genre was not being made, because there were certified, foolproof examples of how it had always failed. So a film on cricket does not work. A film on a period drama does not work. But I knew one thing, that my first two films, having not worked in the box office, put me in a kind of a vulnerable position. You know, my directorial career was almost finished. And my acting career is what I was going to depend on. And at such a time when I decided to write Lagaan, I realized that if I have to come back as a director, it has to be with this. Once I knew that if I convinced Aamir to play the part, and if I convinced him to produce it, then everything would be simple. Because Aamir himself was, even at that time, he was a huge star. And he already had created a brand for himself where, you know, people would wait for Aamir's film to come out, because he was doing only one film at a time, one film a year.
Correct me if I'm wrong, but I read somewhere that it was 25 crores back then, or was it more or less?
Yeah, 25 crores is the figure. That is correct. Yeah.
What were the roadblocks in getting somebody to convince to put that kind of a money and shoot in real locations? Like, I mean, we're really talking about something that was definitely ahead of time.
Yeah. But you know, once Aamir said yes, then I had a wish list. I had a wish list of a few head of departments that I really was very keen to work with. To give an example, Yaar Rehman, Javed Akhtar Saab, Saroj Khan, Bhanu Athaiya ji, who was our only Oscar award winner at that time. And I also told Aamir that, you know, if we have the British actors, I want to get them from London, not cast them within India, find actors from India. So this is my wish list. But Aamir was so, as an actor, was so enamored with the script that he knew exactly what I was talking about. And hence he said that, you know, I will give you everything that you want. With Aamir backing it as a producer also, it became plausible.
You know, you had a huge cast. You've taken some brilliant names yourself. If I were to ask you to pick your one favorite character in the film, who will that be?
I cannot single out a character. But if you put a gun to my head and say that ek bolna hi padega, I would say Bhuvan. because Bhuvan is the, he's the fulcrum of the film. And from him emanates everything else.
As a viewer, if I could say, then I think Kachra with time has really struck with people. Yeah. You know, I think that just the fact that he was the last person to come on the team and really goes to show that, you know, once you start looking beyond your spectacle of discrimination within yourselves, you can really overcome it. How did that character come to you? And, you know, were there things about the character that you sort of kept enhancing while doing it? Or was it how it was?
It was the way it came out on screen. It was planned to be like that. But he became one of the most important elements to be added right at the end in the formation of the team. Because somewhere I wanted the entire team to have not only different occupational backgrounds, but also they belong to different starters of society.
Hmm.
And these were times when, you know, it's like the late 19th century, even the caste system was very strongly prevalent in the village. Not as a protest, but as that's the way of life. Now, in that, to utilize someone who also is a little physically handicapped, but to identify that this guy has got a special talent, and if he has that talent, it should be utilized. To find that and single him out and then convince everyone to take him in became, it was unheard of. So it becomes more believable when you see the film that, oh my God, we need this guy for the team.
If there was something about the film that if you were making today, you would want to add or want to change?
I would definitely make it exactly the way I've made it. But there would be one correction that I would like to do. And that correction is that when we made the film then, it was 4 hours, 5 minutes, the first cut that we had. And we had removed 18 or 20 minutes of an entire track, which was Captain Russell arresting the villagers, putting them behind bars, and then framing them in a thievery. Elizabeth coming and then rescuing them. It was a very interesting track with a lot of romance that was entwined between the three of them, one, Gauri and Elizabeth. Now that had to go. Today, if I have to make the film, I will somehow try and keep that inclusive of the 3 hours, 42 minutes, so that audiences are able to enjoy that also, which is a tall order, but I would have loved to do that.
I want to talk to you about the final scene, like the where it's, you know, they win it. I mean, we as audience really feel the thrill when we watch it. You know? What was the sentiment like when you were shooting it? I'm guessing it was very technical, but agar kuch emotion tha waha, to please. Please tell us.
Every aspect of the character that we had showcased so far had to perform. And when he has to perform, he has to perform while playing cricket, and he has to convince you that he did his best. So getting these guys to play cricket in a convincing manner, filming the entire cricket match, the way Anil Mehta, our DOP, has captured it, where, you know, we had different times of the day. The sun would travel right across at different times of the day, but we had to make it look seamless by trying to show you in a manner where that it is really sunny all the time. While creating that, the match had to be the most convincing and most believable. So the care that we had to take was to make sure that all the nuances are perfect. The physical aspect of shooting it was hard work. I mean, I'm not even discussing the physical aspect of it. It took us 40 days to shoot it. The day I heard that in the theaters when the film came out and in the climax, the entire audience had, you know, whistling and clapping and standing up on their seats and creating a whole joyous ruckus, we realized that we have succeeded in creating a cricket match, which is interactively engaged. So I think that was the toughest one.
Lagaan was the film that put you on the map, you know. You also spoke about, you know, your directorial career sort of finishing. How did things change for you? What were the general sort of differences that you could notice once Lagaan sort of started catching up with the audiences?
Oh, yeah, there's nothing sweet like success, of course. And so after Lagaan released, then, you know, I spent probably a year or two just enjoying the success of the band by way of, you know, going to theaters, viewing the film, traveled with the film to festivals, went to Locarno Film Festival, and then of course the entire Academy, the Oscars, and did all the, there are a lot of things that we have fear of because of the past.
Yeah.
Lagan's success made me get rid of those fears. I realized that I want to tell stories which have not been told before. I want to tell stories which are part of history, which have never come to the screen, which have just become chapters, and there's nothing left to our imagination. But cinema becomes such an important medium that it gives a visual to that part of history. So I really rediscovered myself for my likes and dislikes as a filmmaker, about what kind of stories I want to tell.
Right. You know, my final question to you is that we've seen, like, of course, like, Lagan became a very popular film, but with respect to Academy, we've always seen that a little bit of India, like a little bit of poverty shown, it's just something that strikes to the international audiences.
Yeah.
Do you think it's true for a movie that goes for Academy, for the Oscars, that has to be one of the things, like even this year, like we did see that being the tone in the nominations with The White Tiger, we did see that was the conversation. Do you think that's true, or that's just something that we make it out of? Or because there are so many films being made, you know, Ashutosh, and they don't hit the mark when it comes to the Oscars.
No, I think that a film has to engage for what it stands for, whatever the kind of film it may be, whatever the genre it can be. But definitely in the international circuit, people make a beeline for topics and themes which have either stories about the human condition, which are tragic stories about the human condition, about humanity, about the oppressor versus the oppressed, about underdogs achieving the impossible. These are very common motives and common themes that are very immediately connected for an audience.
Mm-hmm.
And the reason why Lagan probably got one of the nominations at that time was that Lagan has these all three aspects in it. But the special thing about Lagan was this was a mainstream Hindi cinema film that had come out with song and dance, and which also talked about all this. So it became a strange concoction. A lot of people would say, you know, if you had song and dance, it cannot go to the Academy. You know, song and dance cannot win an award at a film festival, you know, international film festival. Those are the norms. But Lagan somehow broke that. So for me, that was a realization that it doesn't matter what the past is.
Yeah.
The thing that you're creating, how does it impact people?
Right. Thank you so much, Ashutosh. And always great to watch Lagan. Like
thank
so
you.
Many others. Thank you so much for this chat.
Lovely talking to you.